Hiya, good afternoon, everybody. Thank you so much for attending this info session. Well, my name is Monica. I work for the Embassy of Spain, and I'm actually located here in Los Angeles at the Education Office. It's a pleasure for, well, my camera off. Okay, it's on again. So it's a pleasure for me to be here with all of you. So thank you so much for the invitation. I'm going to tell you about a fantastic international opportunity that we, the Education Office, has. And we send every year more than 4,000 students like you to Spain to work as a teaching assistant and to learn Spanish, live in a different culture, and have like these 8 months of an international experience in Spain. I'm going to show you a presentation. I'm going to go through a presentation with you, and then you can ask me as many questions as you need. So I'm going to share the screen with you. Let me see. I want to share, yeah, the screen and the sound. Okay, I think I'm sharing now the screen. So I'm just gonna, that's it. That's the presentation. Okay, so this is the program that we have, which is one of our most successful programs here in the US for US students. And its name is North American Language and Culture Assistance Program, NALCAP. And we are now actually promoting the program for next school year. This is school year 2021-2022. Let me show you first of all a short video in which you have the main characteristics of the program. Let's go through the video first.
Fancy living in Spain? Join the Language and Culture Assistance Program of the Education Office of the Spanish Embassy. It offers a fantastic opportunity to spend a school year in Spain as an assistant teacher, sharing your language and knowledge with Spanish students K through 12 and adults.
Con ella aprender inglés es estupendo.
Chloe es la mejor.
I got medical insurance and a monthly allowance to help pay for accommodation and expenses. And I really think that this experience will help with my career in the future.
Spain also offers you amazing travel and cultural possibilities.
I couldn't have imagined this was going to be such a life-changing experience.
And what about the food?
And the lively streets.
And the wonderful people.
Yo he mejorado mucho mi español.
Don't miss this opportunity. Learn more about the Language and Culture Assistance Program of the Education Office of the Embassy of Spain.
And grow as you share.
So, this is the program. I'm gonna go now through some details about the program to tell you like more like deeply how it works and what the program can bring to you. So, let's see what the program is generally about. This is a program which the Ministry of Education in Spain runs. And then we offer the opportunity to American students like you that are native speakers of English to go to Spain for 8 months and to work at a Spanish school as teaching assistants. Then you, once you are in Spain, you also learn about the Spanish culture, you learn Spanish. If you already speak Spanish, you improve your Spanish. And it's also an opportunity for you to add something to your career and to your CV that you can use when you come back here to the States to look for a job, for example. So it's a whole international and cultural experience. So where will you be sharing your language and culture? Where are these more than 4,000 positions that we offer every year in Spain? We have positions as a language teaching assistant at elementary schools, at secondary schools, which is what here you call middle and high schools, and also at language schools, which are schools for adults, which are similar to the community colleges here that adult people go to learn English in this case, and that's in Spain. So why Spain? What does Spain offer to you? Why is Spain attractive for you to go and to spend 8 months of your life teaching English at Spanish schools? I don't know if you've been to Spain, but Spain is an old country in Europe with a lot of traditions, festivals, celebration, history. So I'm sure that you've heard about this tradition, which takes place every year in the north of Spain, in Pamplona, which is pretty popular. This is another festival that we have. This is like more fun, and that happens in the east coast of Spain every summer. The east coast of Spain is also famous for this celebration, which is called Fallas, and that's in March every year in that part of Spain. So we have a lot of, you know, history, celebration, festivals. It's an old country, so we have, like, you know, architecture, old towns, which are just amazing. So if you like history, architecture, you will definitely love Spain. You will enjoy that in Spain. We also have museums, cultural life, beaches. Beaches are nice in Spain. Well, here we have very nice beaches as well, but in Spain you also can enjoy all the coast with its beaches and the islands, which have fabulous landscapes. We have ski resorts, so if you like skiing, you have also this opportunity, theaters, museums, and the food. Spain is also very popular for its food. So this is probably the most known dish in Spain, which is the paella. So you might have heard about that. And we are also famous for this dessert or breakfast with this chocolate and churros. So this is very popular as well. So Spain is a very diverse country, and it has many, many things to offer to you, from beaches, mountains, cultural life, activities, food, travel. So I'm sure you love Spain. Spain is divided into these regions, and these regions would be like the, a state here. So we have different parts, and each region is a bit different from the others. So it has its own traditions, in its own history. So it's good that you know that we are divided into these smaller parts. And there are also the island, the Balearic Islands on the east coast, which is where I come from, and then the Canary Islands down in the south. So what are the requirements to apply for the program? It's very simple. You don't need many things. First of all, you need to be a native speaker of English, so English being your main language. You need to be a US citizen and have your US passport. Then, this is not mandatory, this is not a requirement for the program, but we suggest that people have a basic level of Spanish because then it's easier for you to communicate. But this is not a requirement. If you speak a bit of Spanish, that would be better for you, because when you arrive, you'll be able to communicate. But if not, you will learn Spanish because you will be involved, immersed in a Spanish-speaking society. So you will learn. And then you have to be either a junior or senior student at college. You can already be graduated, so you can apply for the program once you graduate, that's also fine. You can also apply if you have an associate degree from a community college. And for community colleges students, they can apply if they are at their last semester of studies. So that's it. Then you need to be in good physical and mental conditions, health. We also ask for a clean background check. That's another requirement. And then there is an age limit, which is at 60. So you have plenty of time to apply for the program. So after you graduate, you still have many years ahead to be a language assistant in Spain. So this is what you need. As long as you have these requirements, you can apply for the program. And what will you be doing in Spain? What are your duties in Spain? What does a teaching language assistant do in Spain? So you will be a teacher assistant. So that means that you will be working all the time under the supervision of the official and regular English teacher. So you will be never left alone in the class. You won't be responsible for correcting exams, marking. You won't do anything of that. You will be just helping the English teachers in Spain, teaching either English, like English grammar, English language, or a subject in English. Let's say maths in English, science in English. So that's the basic duty of the teacher assistants. So you help them, you know, with the English classes, and then the Spanish kids learn a better English because they have a native speaker in the class, which is very good for the Spanish kids and for the Spanish schools. So these are the duties of a language assistant. Basically, you will work a lot on speaking, conversation lessons. What we want in Spain is that our, you know, kids in Spain learn and speak English. So you will be helping them with speaking activities, make them speak. You will be helping with their pronunciation. So you will be like the model, you know, of a native speaker speaking English so they can imitate and ask you for vocabulary. So it's a lot of speaking activities involving your duties. Then, since it's also a cultural experience, you will be sharing cultural presentations about your country, your town, your traditions. So imagine that at Christmas time, so you can talk about how you celebrate Christmas here or how you celebrate Thanksgiving that we don't do in Spain. So these kinds of things, sharing not only language, but also culture, because we want, you know, the kids to learn from different cultures. And then you'll be at the school for the whole school year, which means that you will be like a teacher. You will be part of the school system. So you will be attending meetings and you will be doing like many things at the department, at the English department. So you will be like a teacher, but you won't, yeah, because you won't be in charge of a class. You will be assisting the English teachers. And also another thing that the language assistants do is to participate in all kinds of activities that the school organizes, such as workshops, cultural activities, field trips, if the school goes somewhere else, like for a trip, so you might join them and go with them, so you are with the kids, so you can join the school play, musical performances, sports events. So any kind of activity that the school organizes, you will be joining as, you know, one more person at the school team. What are the conditions of the program? That's very important here. So what does the program offer to you? What's the opportunity? So first of all, you will receive a monthly stipend, money, which goes from 700 to 1,000 euros, and that depends on the Spanish region that you work as a language assistant. And this is your living wage. If we think of this amount of money from here, from the United States, we might think that that's not a lot of money. But you have to take into account that Spain is much cheaper than the United States. like probably things are like half price, especially rents. Rents are much higher here at the United States than in Spain. So this amount of money is an amount of money that many Spanish families earn every month. So this is what they have for a living on a month regular basis. So that's not a bad money in Spain. I mean that here, you know, the differences are big regarding money, but that's okay in Spain. So you can make a living. So the program runs for 8 months, from October the 1st till May the 31st, which is kind of the more or less the Spanish school year. So it's for 8 months for the school year. You are in the school, at the school, teaching English, helping, teaching English between 12 and 16 hours a week, which means that is a kind of part-time job. And then you normally have a long weekend because the school gives you either a Friday or Monday off. So you have these long weekends and you can visit other cities in Spain. You can travel. Spain has a very successful and very easy and affordable public transportation. So it's very easy to go from one city to another and from one region to another, and things, you know, distances are much shorter in Spain than here in the United States. So it's a good opportunity for you at the weekends to visit other places in Spain and to travel a little bit. You also have medical insurance included in the program, so you don't have to worry about that. And then when you apply for the NALCA program, they ask you to choose three regions, the three regions that you think that you would, you know, like the most to live in. And then they assign you one of these three regions that you have chosen. So that's why we recommend that you do a little bit of research and to get to know a little bit these regions. So you apply for three and they give you one of these three regions. You have to find your own accommodation, your apartment. This is not included. This is what you pay with this monthly stipend that you get. And the schools might help you to find, you know, your apartment, your accommodation. What language assistants normally do is that they share an apartment with another student or with two students as well that are at the same school or at a school nearby. So then the rent, you know, is cheaper because you divide it into two or three, or or the other people that you're living with. But this is one thing that you have to look, you know, when you arrive in Spain. Another thing that is important to take into account when you apply for the program is that bigger cities in Spain are more expensive than small towns. I think this happens like everywhere. So if you go to Madrid, Barcelona, which are amazing cities with many things to do, a lot of, you know, cultural activities, life in the streets, they are fantastic cities, but they are more expensive than a small town. So you have to take that into account because sometimes people prefer to be in a smaller town and to go to these big cities at the weekend and then go back to this town instead of being in a big city in which you spend more money in the rent, basically. That's the difference. At the beginning of the school year, when you arrive, you have an orientation course in which you meet other students like you that are in Spain and they give you some tips and ideas and materials for you. And when you finish, you have this official certificate from the Ministry of Education in Spain that is official and that you can use when you come back here to look for a job and you can use for your, you know, career. So it's valid here in the United States. And then you also have vacations, which are paid for you, but you don't go to the school. And that's when many people go and travel around Spain, or they even travel in Europe because everything is like closer. So you can go to London, you can go to Paris, you can go to Rome. In 3 hours, you are in different countries in Europe. So it's very easy also to travel around Europe, and it's not expensive. And then you can also renew for a second year. So if you want to stay for a second year and you have a positive evaluation from the school, you can stay 2 years. And actually many, many language assistants stay for this second year, because like in 8 months, yeah, you can do many things, but maybe you still want, you know, to be a little more time in Spain. You like the experience, you've met new friends, you like the school. So many of them stay for a second year and they travel even more. For this next year, the application period opens this month on the 27th and closes in April the 6th. So we are now, you know, promoting the program for, let's say, going to Spain in October 2021 till May 2022. The application process is free, so you don't have to pay anything to apply for the program. This is our website. So if you Google the name of the program, NALCAP, this is the first website that normally comes up on Google. And here we have all the information that you need. We update the documents. You have also a guideline for you to apply to the program, experiences from past students that have been in Spain. So here you can find, you know, a lot of information. And let me now show you a video of a student from California, from San Diego, that went to Spain and spent like a year in Spain. And you'll see how many things he did and how many places he visited. Let's watch the video.
California, 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 California,
Yeah. So as you can see, this student went to Spain and he worked at the school. He was teaching English, but it's more than that. Yeah. The whole experience involved so many other things. You saw that the activities in the class were like singing, speaking, these musical festivals, the play that he participated in. So it was like fun. I mean, you are at the class and you teach English, but it's more, you know, in a more funny way rather than the grammar class of English, for example. And he also visited many places, many cities. He went to Portugal on a school trip. So this is what happens when you go to Spain as a language assistant. You not only work and teach English, you also have this experience, which is much more than that. And you also grow as a person. You have this cultural experience. You live in a different country for a year. So that makes you, you know, somehow have this different experience that not everybody has. So it's a great opportunity for you, we believe. So that is the program. So now you know about, you know, the main features of the program, what it involves, when you apply, what are the requirements. So we really think it's a great opportunity for students like you to live this experience. And we are very proud and very happy that more than 4,000 of students go to Spain every year on a regular basis. So we've had this program for many years and we still have it for many more years. So maybe if you, I don't know, you have other plans or you don't fulfill all the requirements now, so you can remember that this program exists and maybe apply next year or the year after or when you graduate. But still, you know that we are here to help you and to bring you this opportunity to be in Spain for 8 months. I'm gonna probably now stop sharing and see if you have any questions. And I'll drop my email on the chat, so you can have, you know, my email and ask me questions if you think of a question, maybe not now, but maybe sometime later. So let me stop sharing. Okay, and that's the chat. Okay, so I'm just gonna drop my email address.
Thank you so much, Monica. And while Monica's doing that, do any of you guys have questions? I'm sure you guys have questions. I have a bunch of questions too. If you have any questions, feel free to speak out or just put your questions in the chat and I'll go ahead and monitor that and we'll take the next few minutes asking questions.
I have a question. I was wondering if the application is going to be in English or Spanish.
It's in English.
Okay.
The platform, it's in English. Yeah, the platform, it was in Spanish only some years ago, but now it's in English. Yeah, and you need to write a letter of motivation, which is this is one of the things that we ask for at the application. So you need to explain why you want to be a language assistant in Spain. And that's in English. It's in English all the time.
Mm-hmm. Hi, I was wondering what would be the COVID modifications for, because I'm assuming that it starts for, would you say October
2021.
So this year,